Thank you. And causes of success. May you have the confidence to always do your best. May you take no effort in your being generous, sharing what you can, nothing more, nothing less. May you know the meaning of the word happiness. May you always lead from the beating in your chest. May you be treated like an esteemed guest. May you get to rest, may you catch your breath. May the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Whoa. May the road less paved be the road that you follow. Oh. Well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we're gonna have. You don't need money, got a free pass. Here's to the fact that I'd be sad without you. I want you to have it all. A slap bracelet. May you keep the chaos and the clutter off your desk. May you have unquestionable health and less stress. Having no possessions, though immeasurable wealth. May you get a gold star on your next test. May your educated guesses always be correct. And may you win prizes shining like diamonds. May you really own it each moment to the next. Or may the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Whoa. Or may the road less paved be the road that you follow. Oh. Well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we're gonna have. You don't need money, you got a free pass. Here's to the fact that I'd be sad without you. I want you to have it all.
To have it. promises. If you believe it, then anything can happen. Go, 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 raise your glasses. Go, 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 you can have it all. I toast you, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna
break. Ooh, somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, and the dreams that you dream of once in a love goodbye. I, oh, somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. And the dreams that you dream of, dream really deep and true. Dream that you did to, oh why can't I, oh, someday wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind, be where trouble melts like a lemon drop, high above the chimney top, that's where.
Welcome to the 48th commencement of Fremont Christian School. Today we are celebrating the graduation of the class of 2023. In the New Testament letter to James, chapter 1, verse 5, it reads, "But if any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask God, who gives to all generously and without reproach, and it will be given to him." Let us pray for wisdom for our graduates. Pray with me. Dear God, we ask that you help our children as they walk in your wisdom and grace. We pray for spiritual eyes and discernment in all things. Help them to be wise leaders and influencers in this generation, not conformed to this world, but transformed by your power. We ask that you would equip them with all that they need to make a difference for your purposes. Help them to live as salt and light in a dark world that so desperately needs to know your truth. We ask for your power to help them to walk continually in honesty and integrity. Build within them a deep godliness, that they would be more concerned about their character than their reputation. We pray that they would seek to bring you honor in all their lives, that they would have a vision and a heart for the world, extend their boundaries and give them an incredible influence, make their hearts and spirits open to every plan and purpose you have for them, and to be willing to go wherever you call. We pray this in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Good morning, everyone. Well, we are congratulating and applauding the students. I would like to congratulate and applaud you parents. Can we give yourselves a hand? You made it. They're graduating, but you made it. Now maybe you can have a little moment to exhale, at least for a little while. My name is Vanji Lopez. I'm on the board of Fremont Christian School, and I'm a member of this church, Harbor Light. Graduates, well done. Good job, you finally made it. And I guess what's next? Parties, celebrating, hanging out together, maybe Disneyland or wherever else you're going to go. Have a wonderful time. You'll never forget this day, graduating from Fremont Christian School. You met the challenges head on. A zillion of them. What is next? Psalm 18:30 from the Message Translation says, "What a God! His road stretches straight and smooth. Every God direction road is road tested. Everyone who runs toward him makes it." We pray that for every step you take on this road called life, you run toward God. Preparation meeting opportunity. Preparation on your part, opportunities presented to you by Holy Spirit, your life will unfold for his honor and his glory. Parents, these were challenging times, and only the hand of God could help you navigate through this obstacle course of raising children during these times. But our mighty, loving God was there with you every moment you sacrificed your time, your finances, your sleep. He was right there with you, for you were chosen to be the parents of these children for this time and for this place. You were not alone, parents. You were not alone. You chose wisely. You chose Fremont Christian School to partner with you, where God-given guidance was everywhere on this campus, where education, yes, was a priority, yet eternity with Jesus was paramount. Students, you were chosen to be born at the right time, chosen to graduate at this time from this school for a reason. Yes, chosen to attend Fremont Christian School, to be prayed over daily in the name of Jesus by this leadership, taught by this faculty, and supported by this church, Harbor Light. What's next? How will you find your way in life, charting a course of purpose and fulfillment? We pray you turn to the most loving GPS ever. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways submit to him, and he will make your path straight." Well done, graduating class, parents, good and faithful servants. Congratulations, Fremont Christian School, graduating class of travel of 2023. Go with God. Amen. Amen.
Excuse me, give me a sec, sorry. All right, so good morning. How are we all doing today? All right, that's good to see. I feel very blessed to have the opportunity to speak to you today. And if it weren't for Jesus, I wouldn't be here today, you know, preparing for the next adventure of my life. I was born at 24 weeks, so I guess you could say I was born at a very young age. Yeah. And because of this, my lungs and heart weren't fully developed, and according to the doctors, my chances of survival were 50-50. My survival was a miracle, and I know that Jesus had been watching over me since before I was born. As I grew, I had more close shaves with death. I needed heart surgery to stay alive, and I have a scar on my back that will stay with me forever. Now, I've come to see the scar as a symbol of how I've grown in all aspects of my life. As one part of me grows, another part grows at the same time. Now, I come from what I would consider a typical Chinese immigrant family. My dad's a principal engineer, my mother's a tax attorney, and my older sister works as a corporate security lawyer. Yeah. My younger sister is, Marilyn, is also graduating from FCS with me today, and that's great. Congratulations. Let's go. Woo! Yeah. I was originally slated to attend Mission San Jose High School, which is a typically large public high school known for its academically competitive environment. However, the Lord had different plans for Marilyn and I. Our parents were concerned with a school environment of unhealthy competition, possibly leading to isolation and depression. They wanted us to be well-rounded individuals with sound minds, bodies, and spirits in a smaller school with a strong sense of community. So we found ourselves at FCS at the beginning of high school. Now, when I first came to FCS in 2019, I was unaware of what being a Christian actually meant. My time at FCS has helped me come to know Jesus, and I have seen the impact he has had on me. Looking back, if I had the choice of whether or not to attend FCS, I would leap at the chance. In my past 4 years at FCS, I have had immense growth academically, physically, and spiritually. But most importantly, I've developed a strong sense of community. Now, I'd like to share some examples of teachers who have shown me how FCS's mission statement has been fulfilled. For a sound mind, I'd like to give thanks to Mr. Paranon, who has been my history teacher, and Mr. Miller, who has been my Bible teacher. Both Mr. Paranon and Mr. Miller have taught me in ways that make me think deeply, and without them, I would not be who I am today. They have taught me how to analyze the significance of primary and secondary sources and the importance of thinking in context. One of my classroom experiences that pushed my thinking was Mr. Perignon's discussion of the Vietnam War in my US history class. This pushed my thinking to wonder when it became necessary for the United States to intervene in foreign affairs and the moral implications of such intervention. And when I asked Mr. Perignon about this topic, he argued that foreign intervention becomes necessary when the rights of the individuals in the area are being taken away from them by force, citing the current conflict in Ukraine as an example. He helped me start our school's first history club and encouraged me to take additional challenging history courses through UC Scout. He also gave me encouraging feedback about the essays I wrote in the course, saying that one of my comparisons between the Byzantine Empire and the Tang Dynasty of China was brilliant. So that's cool. Mr. Miller has always challenged our classmates' viewpoints and thoughtfully questioned our assumptions and opinions in class. He did this to empower us and help us start thinking deeply about the positions we believed in. His approach of teaching through debates and questioning has shown me that I still have much to learn. These challenges helped me grow my interest in history, which is my future major in college. Now, for a sound body, I'd like to give thanks to Mr. Fu, Coach Dunn, and Coach Peterson, who have loved and strengthened me. Mr. Fu, Coach Dunn, and Coach Peterson have inspired me to keep trying my best in all my endeavors, because when we get out of our comfort zones, we grow, regardless of the level of our success. And that's pretty important. That's a pretty important lesson that I'll take with me. Coach Dunn inspired me in particular by telling me that God blesses people with different talents. Some people are born to be athletes, and some are not. The most important thing God shows us is that as long as we give it our best shot, we will improve. These words strengthen me each day. This year, I started competing in FCS's track and field team, and my athletic performance has improved significantly since the beginning of the year. That's something I never thought would happen so dramatically. And as a thrower, my technique and strength have improved at each meet, and I was setting new personal records. During my first meet at BCL East meet number one, I threw 55.05 feet in the discus event. However, by the time the championship meet rolled around a few months later, I had improved and threw 70.9 feet, which is a 15.85 feet increase. That's pretty nice. Yes. And lastly, for a sound spirit, I'd like to give thanks to Mr. B, who has been a role model to me for Christian values and has led me to understand Jesus on a personal level. Thank you, Mr. B, if you're here. Mr. B has led me in pursuit of musical excellence since I first joined the FCS community. When I first arrived at FCS, Marilyn and I found the environment foreign and didn't know where to go. Mr. B was one of the first teachers who approached us and said, "You must be Edward and Marilyn. My name is Thomas Banuelos, but everyone here calls me Mr. B. Let me show you around," and I'll never forget that. He helped orient Marilyn and I around campus before the school year started. His welcoming attitude and patience as an educator has shown me what a follower of Jesus can be when they adhere to Jesus' commandment to love your neighbor as yourself. Under Mr. B's leadership, my classmates and I have performed at numerous concerts in a variety of venues, in FCS's high school chapel band, cardinal band, and of course, the traditional jazz band. Last summer, Mr. B encouraged me to attend the Sacramento Jazz Education Foundation's Tea Garden Jazz Camp, where I not only increased my level of proficiency in jazz trumpet, but also forged strong friendships with my fellow musicians from all over the United States. This year, with his guidance, I performed at the Sacramento Jazz Education Foundation's Tea Garden Jazz Festival and received a scholarship for my performance in jazz trumpet. Thank you. Thank you. Mr. B has demonstrated the importance of service to me not only inside the classroom, but outside of school. He introduced me to his church, which is Sandoval Presbyterian Church, if anyone's interested in coming this Sunday, where I go on Sundays to play in the church orchestra and work as a technician for the church's worship services. At CPC, I have made many new friends who have strengthened my faith in Jesus and have shown me the power of his message. All of my teachers at FCS have challenged me, shown me what being loved and showing love means, and have strengthened me physically, mentally, and spiritually. I will miss them as I move on to the next chapter of my life. I'm sorry, I'm trying not to cry here. Just give me a sec. Before coming to FCS, I had no sense of community to speak of. I didn't believe in Jesus, and I was out of my element. I had no friends and had little motivation to do well in school. However, FCS's welcoming environment soon won me over, and I began to step out of my comfort zone. I started making new friends and taking more rigorous courses like AP Calculus AB and AP Biology in 10th grade. I joined the traditional jazz band. I joined chapel band and the worship team, and I have no regrets. I've developed new habits like daily prayer and reading my Bible. This year, I started doing sports and singing in concert choir and with the chamber singers, and I have become more involved with my local church. I am confident that I would not be who I am today if I did not come to FCS. The community here is fantastic, caring, and nurtures each other. After arriving at FCS, my own sense of community has deepened, as has my relationship with Jesus. One of the highlights of my high school experience would definitely be the New York trip for concert choir, where we had the opportunity to perform in Carnegie Hall. During the trip, Mr. Fu and Mr. Castro both taught me how to be more considerate and look out for international students, which has significantly changed the way that I think. After the trip, I realized that we here at FCS are just like one large family. This has strengthened my friendships and helped me become more welcoming than I was before. And the best part of all is that my story isn't just mine. Many of my classmates have the same stories of the love, care, opportunity, and Jesus they've experienced at FCS. I have loved every minute of attending this school. Lastly, I'd like to leave you all with a Bible verse, which reminds us of the hope we have in Jesus Christ, because without him, we are nothing. One of my favorite verses in the Bible is God's prophecy in the book of Ezekiel, where he declares that he himself will seek out his sheep and deliver them from slavery. Ezekiel 34, 11 through 12 states, "For thus says the Lord God, behold, I myself will search for my sheep and will seek them out. As a shepherd seeks out his flock when he is among his sheep that have been scattered, so will I seek out my sheep, and I will rescue them from all places where they have been scattered on a day of clouds and thick darkness." This Bible passage was addressed to the Israelites who had been exiled to live in Babylon, and it teaches that our God is a God who cares for us and will do anything to see us reunited with him again. In this verse, God tells us that because the earthly kings have failed, he will embark on a rescue mission to save us. Jesus told us during his time on earth that he is the good shepherd who will lay down his life for the sheep. In Psalm 23, it famously states, "The Lord is my shepherd." This use of the Lord is an affirmation that God, as the creator of the universe, as Yahweh, cares for me, a sinner. 1 Samuel 17 tells us how David fights for his sheep and delivers them from the jaws of bears and lions, just like how God will fight for us and deliver us, like he fought for David, and like how the Son of David fought death, defeated it, and delivered us from sin and death. Because the earthly kings have failed to protect the sheep, our Lord in heaven, the very creator of the universe, has decided to intervene on our behalf. That's such a hopeful message, and yeah, thank you. Thank you to all the parents who made it possible for your children to attend this institution, and thank you to all the teachers who have built our graduating class on a foundation of Jesus, love, and hope. Thank you to our graduating class of 2023 for making my time at FCS unforgettable. I'll see you all at our reunions. Thank you.
Peace in labor and in rest.
We are men together and in meeting. We are blessed. Peace in coming and in going. Peace in labor and in rest.
We are men together and in meeting. Hello, good morning. On behalf of the Fremont Christian Class of 2023, I would like to welcome all faculty, staff, administrators, alumni, family, friends, and distinguished guests to our graduation ceremony. We are beyond grateful for your presence today as we celebrate an end to a chapter of our lives and the beginning of a new one. First and foremost, thanks be to God for his endless grace and love, for without him, we are nothing. As a wise man used to say, moments will only last moments before they become memories. Throughout this school year, I couldn't help but feel this old adage become increasingly prevalent in my life, knowing that these may as well be the last moments that we have together. Despite this reality, we choose to celebrate today, celebrating where we started and how far we have come, celebrating our countless accomplishments, celebrating our time here together at Fremont Christian, and celebrating the memories that we have created. Thanks be to God for all that we have and all that we are, for without him, we are nothing. Now, moments. We'll remember the moment that we watched the sunrise and the sunset together. We'll remember the league championships we won together. We'll remember the times we watched movies together, the many trips and adventures we went on together, the video games we played together. We'll remember going through the college application process together. We'll remember the clubs we started together. We'll remember how we were there for each other during the AP exams and how we celebrated together after finals. We'll remember when we won Spirit Week together. We'll remember how we all went to prom together. As our moments here at FCS are coming to a close, I believe our time here was well spent. We have all grown and matured in so many different ways and have gone through countless trials and tribulations in order to stand here today. As we experienced the exciting but grueling life of a high schooler, we grew in understanding and learned to thrive in many aspects of our lives. I can confidently say that we all stand here today as a person with more hope, with more friends, with more knowledge, and with more fulfilled goals than when we first arrived. But as we celebrate our huge accomplishment today, may we never forget that we did not do it alone. Thank you to all the teachers and administrators for making our experience here at Fremont Christian such a joy and pleasure. Without you, we would not have been able to create these amazing moments that we did here at FCS. Teachers, thank you for always going above and beyond to support us, to care for us, to teach us, and to show us a Christ-like attitude for us to follow an example. You have been one of the main influences in our lives for the past many years, and I thank you for propelling us in the right direction in life. Mrs. and Mr. Dr. Meyer, administrators, thank you for keeping the school afloat. Without the work that you do every day, we would not have been able to receive this wonderful opportunity to attend Fremont Christian. Also, thank you to Mr. Eshelman, Angel, and the rest of service and facility staff. Thank you for all that you have done behind the scenes, to keeping our school fresh and clean, to providing for our countless activities, and to keeping us safe and sound. Thank you for allowing us to be proud to have called this place home for the past many years. Thank you, parents and families, for supporting us in every way along this journey, whether it was emotionally, financially, spiritually. Thank you for being the pillars on which we stand. For without you, there would be no us. Thank you, friends, for making our experience here at FCS one to remember. I will truly miss all of your personalities, all of your abilities, and for your confidence to change the world. And most of all, for all the moments that we shared here together. For me personally, I never planned to attend Fremont Christian for high school, but because of a calling that was beyond my control, here I am. And today as I look back, I dare say that this has been one of the greatest blessings upon my life. For without Fremont Christian, I never would have been able to take all the classes I wanted. I never would have had the opportunity to start a club or join student leadership. I never would have realized my passion to be a spiritual leader. I never would have had such close brothers and sisters in Christ to surround myself with. I never would have been able to win championships with my best friends in multiple sports. I never would have been able to, I never would have thought of joining choir or heck, even performing in a musical. I wouldn't be so happy and proud as I am today. And I definitely wouldn't be as close to my Father in heaven as I feel now. Thank you, Fremont Christian, for taking me in and showing me the true love of God in ways that I never could have imagined. As I close today, I hope to leave off the class of 2023 with words of encouragement. Romans chapter 12, verse 12 says, "Be joyful in hope, patient in your affliction, and faithful in prayer." The next chapter of our lives will be filled with love and joy, yet new trials and tribulations. I pray that at all times we may be joyful in hope, the hope of our eternal salvation through Jesus Christ. May we never be too caught up with the things of this world that we forget the eternal love, righteousness, and salvation that has been given to us by grace and through faith. May we constantly choose to live for the riches of heaven and not the trivial, temporary things of this earth. May we be patient in our affliction. During our times of trouble in the future, may we rest on the promises of the Lord and be committed to the reading of the Word of God, because there we will find our comfort. And lastly, may we pray continuously. This year, the Lord has shown me no shortage of the power of prayer, whether it was the healing of sick, the dealing of stress, or the blessing of accomplishment. The Lord has proven to me through miracles that prayer has the power to change circumstances of the future. I ask that the class of 2023, as we move on from Fremont Christian and into the real world, may we stay committed to prayer, to scripture, to fellowship, for we know and have seen that the power of God is inside anyone who puts their faith in him. I send you off with this, my favorite verse, Joshua 1:9, "Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be terrified. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go." It is true. Moments may only last moments before they become memories. But for today and forevermore, I believe I will cherish these memories forever. Thank you.
It is my pleasure to share with you awards and recognitions for the class of 2023. Parents, thank you for your partnership with us in our common goals. At Fremont Christian School, we have worked to show these students that they are loved and they are valued. We've encouraged them in their knowledge of Jesus Christ. We have made it a priority to give them the tools to think critically as a person of faith and to show care of others above themselves. We desire to graduate students who have developed the skills necessary to be academically successful while also building their confidence through leadership, teamwork, and service. But none of this is accomplished without the engagement of our parents and homestay hosts. As many hours as teachers and staff put in for the benefit of each student, and they are many, parents put in even more. Thank you for being our partner, and thank you for choosing FCS for your family. We want to bring a special recognition to those families who have partnered with the FCS community since kindergarten, and some even since preschool, by recognizing our 13-year students. Recipients, you will stand as your name is called. Christina Bean. Matthew Nguyen. Tobin O'Connell. Hannah Tanaka. And Jonathan Wong. Awards were given to our students at our senior breakfast yesterday, as many of the awards involve a medal, a pin, a stole, a cord, or a ribbon lay to be worn today. This morning, we will recognize the awards that were presented yesterday. Full descriptions of these and many other recognitions for arts, athletics, leadership, and academic achievements earned this year and over all of high school are in your graduation program. The graduation program will also be found at the school website. We will begin with FCS Merit Scholars. Matthew Nguyen. Tobin O'Connell. Hannah Tanaka. And Faith Zachariah. The President's Award for Academic Excellence, Christina Bean. Aaron Chang. Iris Swong. Paul Kanaya. Sunny Liu. Stanley Lowe. Stephen Lowe. Victoria Madry. Gabriel Mercado. Matthew Nguyen. Tobin O'Connell. Daniel Raboka. Harsha Rajkumar. Joshua Ryan. Anita Sun. Justin Wang. Katie Wu. Margaret Chi. Helen Yao. Edward Yuen. Marilyn Yuen. Faith Zachariah. James Zhang. Catherine Zhang. Melody Zhang. And Amy Zhao. Our California Scholarship Federation Lifetime Members, Christina Bean. Adriana Nassar. And Amy Zhao. California Scholarship Federation Lifetime Members with Highest Honors, Samuel So. Hannah Tanaka. And Katie Wu. National Merit Scholars Commended, Sunny Liu. Stephen Lowe. Harsha Rajkumar. Margaret Chi. Helen Yao. Melody Zhang. And Amy Zhao. National Merit Scholar Finalist, Justin Wang. For the College Board National Recognition Award, Gabriel Mercado. The the ACSI Distinguished Christian High School Student Awards. Christina Bean. There are several categories for academics, leadership, fine arts, athletics, and Christian service. Sunny Liu. For academics, leadership, fine arts, and athletics. Stanley Lowe. For academics, leadership, athletics, and Christian service. Stephen Lowe. For academics, leadership, fine arts, athletics, and Christian service. Daniel Raboka. For academics, leadership, and fine arts. Hannah Tanaka. For academics, leadership, fine arts, and athletics. Margaret Chi. For academics and leadership, for Helen Yao. Academics, leadership, fine arts, and athletics. For Faith Zachariah. Academics, leadership, fine arts, athletics, and Christian service. And for Melody Zhang. For academics and fine arts. For the FCS Excellence in High School Disciplines, for Bible, Carl Oscar Hetland. Computer Science, Justin Wang. English, Melody Zhang. Mathematics, Stephen Lowe. Instrumental Music, Helen Yao. Vocal Music, Carl Oscar Hetland. For Physical Science, Melly Zhang. Social Studies, Sunny Liu. And Theater Arts, Daniel Raboka. This year we had two students who received the honor of salutatorians, and they are Stephen Lowe. Stephen Lowe. And Melody Zhang. And our valedictorian of this year's graduating class is Harsha Rajkumar. The Doherty Award, Carl Oscar Hetland. Athletes of the Year, Troy Frazier. Stephen Lowe. And Katie Wu. We would now like to recognize the recipients of scholarships specifically for Fremont Christian School students. CSF Chapter Scholarship, Adriana Nassar. Jason Keith Silvera Memorial Scholarship, Samuel So. The Martina Withy Scholarship, Samuel So. Amy Zhao. And Anita Sun. The Lopez Family Scholarship, Adriana Nassar. Christina Bean. Viola Arishvara. Ruth Arroyo. Amy Zhao. And Paul Kanaya. the Leroy Cloud Fremont Christian School Board Scholarship, Paul Kanaya. Finally, significant to the mission of Fremont Christian School is to provide opportunities for students. These include opportunities to lead, to play a part in the work and success of a team, to cooperate with others in performance, to give and take in a classroom, to show individual accomplishment, to build community with peers and staff. Every student you see in front of you has been challenged to show kindness and humility, manage time, adjust expectations, persevere in stressful circumstances, and more. We are very proud of our students who are scholars, athletes, artists, leaders, and friends. From among a class rich with potential nominees, the faculty and administration has recognized 6 students who embody the mission of Fremont Christian School. We call this award the Silver and Cardinal Shield. Stephen Lowe. Adriana Nassar. Tobin O'Connell. Edward Nguyen. Margaret Chi. And Faith Zachariah. Please join me in congratulating the class of 2023 for their hard work and accomplishments.
Our senior class would now like to say thank you.
And pastries that make you grow tall, forests and cottages, castles and carts that can talk. Welcome to Wonderland, look where you're at, maddest of hatters, the Cheshire Cat, magical cabins and lovely white rabbits with claws. Dancing through a dream underneath the stars, laughing till the morning comes. Everyone that leaves has a heavy heart. Oh, Wonderland, I love. Welcome to Wonderland, I'll be your guide, holding your hand under sapphire skies. Let's go exploring, or we could just go for a walk. Welcome to Wonderland, where should we go? There's a tea party along down the road. Make an appearance and maybe they'll sing us a song. Dancing through a dream underneath the stars, laughing till the morning comes. Everyone that leaves has a heavy heart. Oh, Wonderland, I love. Nothing around here is quite as it seems. Not sure if anything's real or a dream. And the only thing sure from the start is the song that's inside of your heart. Don't let it leave. If this was a dream, then at least I've got memories for when morning wonderland. I love.
At this time, we'll call our graduates back to the stage as we prepare for the big, big, big giving of diplomas.
We are pleased to present diplomas to the graduating class of 2023. Harsha Rohan Rajkumar. Stephen Lowe. Melody Serena Zhang. Viola Aviel Arishvara. Ruth Arroyo. Alexandria Marie Bontugan. Christina Diane Bean. Joshua Cardenas. Aaron Chang. Nicholas James Dieck. Troy Frazier. Gu Ting Ting. Carl Oscar Hetland. Liam Joseph Higgins. Iris 黄宇科, Paul Kimio Kanaya, Ashley Jiang, Liu Shuo, Stanley Low, Victoria Madry, Gabriel Mercado, Adriana Nassar, Matthew Nguyen, Aaron Xavier Nunez, Tobin James O'Connell, Pouget du Alessandra, Daniel Faith Raboka, Joshua Ryan, Samuel So, Sun Jiaqi, Hannah Beat Tanaka, Justin Wang, Jonathan Yuan Wang. Wu Yeqi. Margaret Xi. Yao Zhuxuan. Edward Yuan. Marilyn Yuan. Faith Zachariah. Zhen Zimo. Catherine Zhang. Amy Ding Zhao.
A lot of scholars in this class, but not too many introverts. In my 28 commencements of the 48 that we've been here, you would think I would have graduated by now. But it's always an honor as the pastor of Harbor Light and the chairman of our school board to honor these students and honor you parents and you guests. I noticed, especially this year, that a lot of you have a lot of aunts and uncles by the number of floral leis that you have around your neck. And hopefully they've all been participating in the tuition. I want to pray a special blessing over you, but tell you just about it a minute. A few years ago, Nimroy, who was the character Spock in the Star Trek series, was asked to give a Vulcan sign, and he thought about it, and he came up with a hand motion that he learned in the Hebrew church when he was a young child, and the rabbi would get up and pray the blessing from Numbers 6, 24 through 26. He would raise his hand and make the blessing like this. And all the students and all the church members would be told, the synagogue would be told, to close their eyes because the glory of the Lord would come through that sign into their faces. You can understand when you hear this blessing, you've maybe heard it over and over again. In fact, it became very famous during the COVID period when it was sung by many groups on the internet. But today, I just simply want to pray this blessing over you, but help you to understand that when we pray blessings like this and we hear them over and over again, sometimes they become so common that we don't fully understand their meaning. So please understand today that this blessing that I'm going to pray over you is thousands of years old It was given by God himself to be prayed over his people. So the most important thing for you today is to make sure you're one of his people, because if you are, you can experience this blessing the rest of your life. Now let me pray this blessing over you. I'm going to ask you to stand, and I'm going to ask you to make the sign of the blessing to all these students with me as we pray this blessing over them today. The Lord bless you and keep you, which means may he sustain you, may he provide for you, may he protect you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. When his face shines upon you, you will experience his goodness, his kindness, his affection for you, and his grace toward you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. May you have peace with God. May you have peace with your family. May you have peace with your friend. May you have peace with every other person in this world. And may you honor every tribe, every tongue, and every nation, and live in God's peace. Amen. It is my distinct honor to present to you the graduating class of 2023. Let's hear it for them.